What's going on, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how frames work in Python. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. What's going on, people? We're going to be discussing frames today. A frame is really just a rectangular container to group and hold widgets together. So, we're going to practice using frames today, but first, we'll need a window. We're going to create a frame and add a frame to the window. So, window equals tk followed by window.mainloop. Well, we're going to need some widgets to add to our frame, so let's create a bunch of buttons, because why not? So, I'm going to show you guys a shortcut too. So, let's say button equals button, and then for now, we're going to add this to our window, but we're going to replace this eventually with frame when we create this. And I'm just going to set the text to equal, let's say W. We're going to have four different buttons, WASD, like the buttons on a keyboard if you're playing a game and you want to move forward, left, back, or right. So we're adding this to the window for now. Let's set the text to W. And what else can we do? Let's change the font. So font equals, I'll pick the font Consolas because that tends to be even with buttons. The size of the button adjusts to the size of the letter that you're using or the size of the text. So let's set this to 25 and then a width. So maybe width equals 3. All right, and then button.pack. And I just want to take a look at this. So here's our button W. So I'd like to show you guys a shortcut. If you don't plan on using this button by name, you don't really need to give it a name. You can just say button and then have all your options here. And then instead of having button.pack, just add dot pack to the end. So this will do the same thing. However, you can't adjust this button by its name, though, because it doesn't have a name anymore. So let's create a few other buttons, one for A, S, and D. So we have W, A, S, D. And by default, they're all top and center. So with pack, we can actually put these on a certain side. So let's say we want W on the top, and then the other three will be all left. So side equals left. And then after I show this to you, you'll see the benefits of using a frame. All right, so right now they're all, at least it appears that they're all within a container. So what if I were to expand this? Well, W is just drifting off. It's sailing away by W. So what if we could put these within a frame or container to actually contain all of these widgets? Well, we can. So let's create a frame. Frame equals frame. And instead of adding these buttons to the window, we're going to add these buttons to our frame. And now we need to add the frame to the window. And this is what this looks like. However, we need to actually add this by using pack or place. So frame dot pack. So now what this looks like is that all of these buttons, all of these widgets are now contained within a frame, a container. Let's change the background color of this frame just so that we can see the width and the height of this frame. So when you create your frame, there is an option for background color. It's just BG. And let's set this to a color. We haven't done pink yet. Pink is a very masculine color. So now the background of our frame is pink, and that might be a better visual cue to the bounds of the frame. Let's also give this frame a border. So let's set a width of 5 using BD and then the type of border that we want, and we can specify that with relief. So relief equals, let's say, raised. So this will have a 3D pop effect, kind of like that. Let's try sunken. There's a few other ones as well, but I don't feel like it's necessary to go over all the border types. Let's stick with sunken for now. That'll work. All right, so with this frame, we are currently packing this we can set this on a certain side within our window. So currently it's at the top. Let's set this to maybe the bottom. So side equals bottom. Now this frame is sticking to the bottom of the window, and it still contains all of the buttons, all of the widgets that we added. Another function available to you is the place function. We can place this frame at certain coordinates within our window. So let's set X to equal 0 and Y to equal 0. So then when we place this frame within our window and set some coordinates, this entire frame is going to stick at these coordinates, even if we were to resize this window. And we can change these too. Let's say X is now 100 and Y is also 100. So the frame, along with all of the components, all of the widgets that it contains, are sticking within the container and they move along with this. So that's the basics of frames. It's really just a rectangular container to group and hold widgets together. So if you want a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. And well, yeah, that's how frames work in Python. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.